light pollution is increasing everywhere. It damages our sky views. I live away from the city, on a Bortle 5 location near the ocean. But I'm also affected by the SKYGLOW, neighbor's lights, and this streetlight LED near me.
No!
I knew I had to do something. My old infrared cut filter wasn't working anymore. They were winning, and I needed some help. I called Astro Shop and I bought two filters, the OPTOLONG L-PRO and the Baader NEODYMIUM, but I will keep only one. Let's choose
the winner.
Let's say you are on Bortle 7, 8 or 9 in the middle of a city, full of light pollution. You probably will need a more aggressive filter, like the OPTOLONG L-Extreme and so on. However, in my situation I don't feel the need of an aggressive filter. I just want a filter to cut a bit of the sky glow and the soft light pollution I have. A broadband filter was a good choice, so the OPTOLONG L-PRO is a broadband filter and also the Baader NEODYMIUM. I've made loads of tests with both filters and later in the video I will show you my final decision. I can tell you that I'm very happy with the decision I've made, though. At the first glance I can see the threads from the Baader NEODYMIUM are better, because it has two threads, while the OPTOLONG only has one. This is very important to me, because with the OPTOLONG L-PRO filter, with a single thread, I can't add anything else to the optical train. Which means, if you have the filter near the sensor, as I have, you can't add anything else. It will not screw it. Another advantage of the Baader NEODYMIUM is that can be also used for visual observations. According to different owners of this filter, it's great for observation of Mars and Jupiter. I didn't test it with any eyepiece yet, so my test will be exclusively for imaging purpose.
Let's compare those images.
The first test was with the moon rising at the horizon. In such an extreme circumstance, I choose the Orion Nebula, which is a very bright nebula, easy to watch. This first image is without any filter. I just did it once for this video, for you to see how hard it is to catch anything without a filter. That glow you can see on the image is a mix from my neighbor LED light and my security cameras. This is very important because many people don't know the strong impact the security cameras have because of the infrared they emit. We humans can't see the infrared band. Nonetheless, if you point a camera without an infrared cut filter, you can see all that glow. That's why the infrared cut is very important to have in cameras like these ones that I use, the ZWO-224 and the ZWO-294, which I'm using to this test, and that don't have any infrared filter. And now let's use the infrared filter. We can see a huge difference and the glow has gone. I took each set of pictures at the same time, and now the OPTOLONG L-PRO filter. Let's compare them side by side. Here it's clear that we have more detail and more color in the L-PRO image at the right. Remember, we have the moon, so the L-PRO is doing a good job. In the L-PRO image we can also see an orange tint. Now the Baader NEODYMIUM moon and sky glow filter. This is the image I like the most. Let's compare with the L-PRO. Although both made a good job, the Baader NEODYMIUM at the right has more detail and a more natural color, which is very important to me. Be aware that the L-PRO is a bit more aggressive than the NEODYMIUM. So the purpose of this test is to check if I really need that aggressivity or I can handle with the Baader NEODYMIUM. Now the Running Man Nebula, infrared filter. Like in the previous one, all the images are around 5 minutes with 8 second exposures each. This filter always do a wonderful job with the dust. Now the L-PRO, a bit less of detail in the brown dust of the nebula, however with better detail in the colors. Now the Baader NEODYMIUM. It's impressive how we could catch the best of both. A good performance on the dust lanes and also a good performance with the color. Therefore is my choice for this image. This was under moon conditions. Nonetheless, for curiosity and outside of this test, I've tried again the OPTOLONG L-PRO in this nebula, but without moon, and increasing the exposures to 10 seconds, and I enjoyed the result. You can see this beautiful image. It's a good filter, no doubt. Now it's time for the Thor's helmet. The previous images were taken under the moon influence, security cameras, and my neighbor LED light. This one is in a different situation. We have no moon, but we are pointing over the glow of the city near me and also the influence of the street LED light at my left. The L-PRO made a much better job comparing to the previous one, the infrared cut, catching more detail and color. Now the Baader NEODYMIUM. Very similar to the L-PRO, but while the L-PRO has a tint more greenish, in the Baader NEODYMIUM the tint is bluish. Here I still prefer the Baader NEODYMIUM. Let's place them side by side. Yes, I prefer the one at the right, the NEODYMIUM. And there's another detail that make my preference for the NEODYMIUM. Note that its image has more stars than the L-PRO image, which means that in a region full of stars like this one, the NEODYMIUM will make a better job. Remember that for me it's awesome to have the images the nearest possible of the reality. And all the images you can see in this test are not post-processed. No astrophotography here. Otherwise, I will distort the reality. And now the Ghost of Jupiter Nebula. This is a beautiful planetary nebula in Hydra constellation. My goodness, look at these beauties. This is the real Dobsonian power. Nonetheless, there's not much to say here. They're both similar images. All the details are there, and we can note a subtle greenish tint in the L-PRO image as usual. And now the Bode's Galaxy. The L-PRO with a nice job here. And the NEODYMIUM with a much better job, enhancing all those dust details of the galaxy. And for curiosity, here you have the same image with the infrared cut filter. Really a mess. This galaxy was captured right above the street LED light I have here. Since they change for the LED light, this infrared cut filter lost a lot of power. Here we can also see that the L-PRO turned the background darker, however with the same trade-off as before, losing some of the fainter stars. Something very important to consider. So I choose the NEODYMIUM. Let's see how it works in other galaxies. Now the M65, a galaxy from the Leo triplet in the Leo constellation, with the L-PRO and the NEODYMIUM. For this capture, we are not over the street LED light, we have it at the left, and we are capturing through the SKYGLOW from the city. It's hard to distinguish the difference here, they are both very similar, although I can see the difference of the subtle details here in my monitor. It will be hard for you in your device, but maybe you can see some differences. Last but not least, the M66 in the same triplet, in the Leo constellation. Here we also can see similar images, however, the brown dust lanes of this galaxy are more enhanced in the Baader NEODYMIUM. Interesting to note that while pointing above the streetlight light, as we did with the Bode's galaxy, the L-PRO turns the sky darker. In this one, through the city SKYGLOW, it's the Baader NEODYMIUM that has a better performance in the background. And this has a very simple explanation. My city SKYGLOW is greenish, yellowish, while the street LED light is white. This is why, in my particular situation, the Baader NEODYMIUM has a better performance, because I'm surrounded mostly by a green, yellow sky glow. I only have the white power against me at my left, but even in that position, above the street LED light, the Baader NEODYMIUM does a pretty decent job. This is important because for you, for your particular situation, the choice may be different. What I have as a conclusion is that, from my experience, when I was bortle 4 and below, the infrared cut is the best choice. Now, in my bortle 5, the Baader NEODYMIUM is the best choice. So when I said at the beginning of the video, choose your filters wisely, I mean that you should have in account all those factors to do the best choice. One simple and basic way to analyze that is to look at your sky glow, at your light pollution. If it is white, it's because the new modern LED lights are prevailing. But if it is, like me, with a green or yellow tint, it's because your region still have a lot of old lights, and if they're not too strong, the Baader NEODYMIUM should work better. In addition to that, your setup and the kind of telescope you are using may influence also the way light pollution impacts your images. For instance, an image from an 8-inch Dobsonian may be different from an image from a 12-inch Dobsonian, as you can see here in this video I did with the 8-inch compared to the 12-inch Dobsonian. If you like this video, you know what to do. Thumbs up to the video. And thank you very much for watching.